my client just cashed.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, what? He logged off because he's a loser. Yeah, he was just late. Nope, see ya. Right? Yep. Yeah.
since then, so it felt longer before, so.
Some people are going to cross.
Yeah. Save these little green things from the wisps. Reset now, but just dip into them, don't take the whole thing. Just a kernel. These brambles, just dipping into the green circles. It's really sense to it, you see. Watch the breath. I wish I could see some people start stepping again too high again.
I'm getting too low.
Funny,
I was reading. It does 750 damage AoE.
Do you know where it's going?
Let me. I was reading as you asked.
It would be weird because he wrote for the stomp to be play target and not on the actual. Yeah, but I don't know if going for the wisps makes it easier for healers, but harder for peeps.
Scorn Touch inflicts 731 250 to other shadow damaging cores, causes Scorn Touch to enemies within 8 yards and reduce movement speed by 50%.
I swear it's that section of the water. If you go straight halfway that, it's all weird tree branches. I swear that's very easy to.
It's actually too long.
I saw that on my right front.
But Scorn Touch is from the bitches, but I can't even see the bitches.
There's two players with it as well. Me and someone else right beside me. I'm not sure who it was.
Who?
I don't believe it would spawn all four things at once. Because I believe that probably it's only spawning three at the start. Because we don't see the dryads. Stop.
Maybe we had the dryad, maybe it was dryad, drake, and wisps for the second wave.
I mean, right now nothing spawns in this corner, which I believe is where the dryads are.
We can keep an eye out for it in the second wave, so that's not good for it.
once. Okay, good, that's one done. Next set is we'll see if that's something else. Yeah, throw it to the nature, let's go to the nature. Because that needs to be brought in and needs to be interrupted. Every time. It's like your sergeant in Dragon Slayer, you have to choose which ones you want, which one to jump. Whatever that blob, that ooze. Do we have any, what range slows do we have still in across every
place?
If we went for the Wisp slow, do we have anything?
I still have finding shots, I'm not sure if it's gone from there.
Do they all spawn? No, they spawn across the room, don't they? Which makes it awkward. Let's just try what we've been doing, but on the second set we'll go for the sister, which is kind of where I'm jumping now. So remember, for the second set of ads, it's going to be the sister. Should be past that, yeah. Good, get out of that now, once we sit. Thank you. get to V6 stacks, I don't know. And get ready, what's this, bro? Get ready for the second set, we're going to get the sisters up. Wisp all the way around the corners now, around the edges. Don't kill them, just start kiting them before they die, please. Just start killing them whilst they're on top of you, you're actually all kinds of daft. How much help do you get that? So, I mean, just let them all stack up on top of us, stun them, nuke them, and peace out. Like, just to make sure that none of us is 10 yards, so it's not that far. That debuff, what's it called? The one that Cenarius puts up.
The
for
one
the
reflect. Ahead, ahead,
not for the reflect.
I don't think the wisps do damage when you kill them. I think they do damage when the wisps play. At least it's what it says on the journal.
Okay, I see.
So, you have to protect them. Or stun them.
Is the reflect up all of the time, or is it something that you can move the boss in and out of? Tell you what, let's just keep on clearing the wisps. We'll keep on and we'll deal with, learn to deal with the sisters. They have it's just a dispellable debuff called the javelin. You probably, all you viewers probably seen it already.
I don't think I have. I think it's popping up my preference.
Maybe it's because we haven't had it with hands in long enough, but Malik, just keep watch out for the, it's called Twisted Touch of Life, and it's interrupted because otherwise it's a mad heal. So we're just going to keep on doing this, we'll keep on doing the wisps. So first wave wisp, second wave wisp, just try and get the break down again before the second wave. Doing a really check on GG soon. So first set of that's going to be wisps. Oops. Okay, adds.
whistles again, please. You set your stacks if you need, then get out there, safely. Okay, the sister's here. Bring her away. Kill the sister first this time. Okay, interrupt this one. Someone makes noise. Make sure someone got the noise. Okay, it's a two-person rotation of damage. Make sure you're running out with that debuff. If you got a circle on. Got this one somewhere. Okay, make sure you're out. Good. So we got nature, what else have we got? What have we got? Wisps again. Wisps and nature. Okay, it's fine. If it's a two-person number. But no wisps.
I got hit by the trees here. We stopped by the limit.
So on the third one, do you want to do a sister?
I don't know. I'm just getting with the...
Well, the Treant, gives... mana. Do you healers need mana?
No. I'm running out of mana really quick.
Okay, so we're going to get the tree. It's 3% mana every second. I'm going
to run.
So when it comes to the third wave, there's going to be loads of those debuffs that you guys have to run out for, so just kind of spread it this. If we're not having wisps, then we're not going to have random patches on the ground, so you need to be really careful, and where that Treant spawns that we cleanse is going to be the only place in the room where you can reset your stack, so don't go chilling in it forever, having a sandwich and whatever, have one thing off, just get in and out quick. Ridden in the office. By the roots.
I definitely just time.
Okay. Set your stacks quick so you can hear us walk. From my reserve range, just try not to stand on top of the lead. I think we've got enough in us now to just stop. across those roots now. Yeah, it's not that actual boss itself, it's the biggest group, but I think we will be kind of almost the biggest group if there's people stood in between Cross and Moon as ranged and the melee around the boss as much as we can. It's not as, there's not that much time actually. But I think that we could probably do a little bit more DPS anyways. But I don't think that we're actually clearing all of the green stuff on the floor for the next wave.
Also, are we using any backing to deal with the wisps? Or just because I just saw them chasing someone. That guy was just running away.
Why not?
We're not supposed to.
Okay. I mean, at some point, we will want to deal with them. Anyway.
Locking back in. We haven't had a wave of double wisps. There's more tips and things about it. The positioning we need to see where they actually spawn. It's not going to be anything more than probably trying to clear one side and then fighting the rest turn them before they get to it. We'll do that in here.
The game just crashed. Okay, I'm back in.
Let's go across.
watching stats. Watch the brambles. Come on, Rose, you shouldn't be in there anyway.
Don't heal.
Bazooka, bro. Yeah, but we're getting pushed away by range community. But like, fine, if your class needs it, like I think it's just paladins at the moment. If you're a paladin and you need to heal from melee, fine. But there shouldn't be other people just standing on us, because we're having to be getting pushed away. Pushed away too much.
It's fixating a range on one side of the boss and then fixating one on the other and cutting through melee.
You get the eyes in your face, more for your eyes, so everyone should be able to see it. And I think actually as range we should be able to stack up for it, and then the person who gets it walks out.
Yeah, actually that would be a lot better. Okay, so you can kind of keep Cenarius where he is now, and just move out to blue or something from cross.
They will disappear.
Where did the route start? Where did the route actually start?
I think the route starts from around.
If they're starting from around that area, then you should be on close, or ideally around the room. Just watch where it is, stack up this range, and move out if you get the eyes over you. It's not that difficult. It shouldn't be all over Malik, because you're making us move too far away. And it's splitting right up too much. Zip saving, really? Alright, let's go. Because we're not getting any uptime on scenarios.
Enthusiasm.
Full enthusiasm, thank you.
You're getting better in that,
straight on his head as soon as it's fine. Okay, one of the roots is this one.
If you get fixed, it won't right. It's going back left now.
That's very good. Reset of status as you can. I've got the first interruption.
I can't get up. I'm under the world now. I'll set the bus to get the road.
Just kill yourself quickly on the nuts.
I think roots actually originated from the central of this ship.
The root just falling and whoever it attacks and then follows.
I don't know, but if you need to be in melee as you pass and you get those eyes above your head, just get the fuck out, please. Hit him in the
group. I had the first pick set and came from the melee, and I was trying to dodge everyone, but everyone was pressed.
If it comes from melee, then it probably originates from the boss itself, to be honest.
It should only be like three groups of players, all of the ones on the lead, all of the ones on range, and then people who are actually fixated or have the debuff from the sister. So there shouldn't be anyone just fucking chilling in between. And the only time that you need to think about maybe moving out of that stuff is just reset your stats, which takes like a second.
It's better for the range to start at the top, and then you should then get. The only problem is that one. I have the majority of fixators, and there's no green stuff around here, and I have like 42 stacks.
More stacks, it shrinks water, but so there is no point. When you enter with 40, it shrinks water, than you enter with 20 stacks.
The only problem would be that we have to reset the stacks that could go a bit higher since we eventually will not be able to move so much.
We'll be able to move as soon as someone is fixated. It won't refixate unless we like faint that bit.
Let's have a portal. Or if you actually have that portal ready. To go back to the tree then, or just watch for the ones in between.
Something like that?
Yeah. Okay. Just so just stay the stack top of range and move out one side, move to the right with the roots and to the left with the sister debuff. Just stay in between with slugs on black hands. Do a full time as well. The let's not waste any time now. Or attempts, we need to move some further into the fight.
Oh, wait,
there's no reset now. Who's leading? Yeah.
Yeah, I love you.
Check your stack. Yeah, what's going on there? Reset is dicing it up. We've lost message. We're about range. Roots on the
river. Yeah, there is. Four soul free patches.
Well, ones.
Do I need to get those, blizzards?
What are you healers struggling with most at the moment, damage-wise? Is it something to do with tanks, or is it just the raid damage from the stacks, or...? People be taking dodgeable damage.
It's always like after the first set of dodge.
It's probably been the Drake then. So when he gets low health, it starts. You can kill the Drake first, let's try that actually.
Quick.
That's ridiculous, guys. Come on. You should be watching your stacks all the way through. You'd never be able to do so long on something without resetting your stacks. So you'd never be able to do this without resetting your stacks. Keep those heroes fine. Because, I mean, there's so much place and time to reset. Just dip in and out. Until when you're ready for this cup.
For the fixer.
What's that word? Killing the Drake, bro. Drake first. Reset your stacks whilst you can now, whilst there's still stuff, because they're going to do spawns. Much better. Don't DPS the ad so much until he's up and it's split. Okay, fine. Don't get a message.
Red Thorns is active, which means that you can buy even more damage.
Watch your MLA.
Drake first again, or?
Yeah. The sister's not doing, doesn't seem to be doing too much. People are watching the deal. We can't split though, because the Drake will kill us. He's already at 5 stacks, 6 stacks, we're at 7 stacks last time. Just being creeped on equally, and I don't know why.
Okay, the question is, how are we going to damage the damage?
We're not, I don't think, not as it is. Doesn't sound like.
Is Drake 4 is discovered?
Red Lance out.
The Reflect?
No.
Okay.
Is it Cleanse? Ops go away when power is
discovered? Yes. So you have to do it in between.
Wait, should my item level go up, by the way? I'm 6 at 6 at the moment.
6, 8, 6?
Yeah, so you'd be item level 6, 8, 6.
If you hover over your gear, what's the chart?
Item level is gear, but this
8, 7, 5, skill down to 6, 8, 5. What the fuck?
Yeah,
no, it should be 8, 7, 5, skilled 8, 7. Up. The one in brackets is what it is.
That's great. Well, what does Jesus have to do with this shit? Leave Jesus out of it.
threats. Drake first this time again. That's right. Watching his times.
Okay, this time I reset it at 39%.
Because someone was spamming you, man.
Hey, that is no problem. Hard to hit, even know my name. The hunter that starts with this.
Yeah, I'm a Drake again. I got first interrupt in the system.
They go smaller in, based on the amount you drop.
Just be safe. Someone take the next interrupt on the system. Just keep them safe. Res on men.
Res leader? Is that maybe? Or you want me to accept?
I don't think we're having problems with healing that much at the moment. It seems like we're just behind on killing stuff in time. Especially when it comes to the trade. Reset
check your specs.
I got first on the on cross, so I want to make sure that there's two on there. There's me and Bly on cross. Got next on cross. Wow, whoever just ran in on melee with that debuff, didn't you? And that's a wipe straight because I think it was Stanga.
I was already in melee.
I guess that's all we wanted to probably be able to see quickly which other waves come if people went more DPS. I think that there's a point in this fight where because the Drake does more damage, the longer he's up at low health, he was getting like 9 stacks, but I mean if you could kill it faster by stacking more DPS, then you could probably drop a healer or two even, because it doesn't seem that tight on the debuffs. Anyways, we're going to do the next boss later on if you guys want to stick around. I believe
20 minutes. Assuming
we don't start early. But it's not with this. Other
roads. Right, so.
Back out to Dara and let everyone see you in 20 minutes. If you don't, if people who aren't from UE want to stick around, then stick around. More than welcome.